Hello friends, this is tutorial number 40 in this C++ programming language tutorials. In this tutorial we will talk about recursive function. Okay, what is recursive function? It is a function that can call for itself, for herself. Okay, little difficult to explain, but I will give you example. We want to calculate factorial. And we will calculate factorial, but if you don't know, I'm pretty much sure that you know. But for those who doesn't, I will just give an example. A factorial of number 5, it is 5 multiplied with 4, multiplied with 3, multiplied with 2, and multiplied with 1. Okay, this is a factorial of number 5. If we want to calculate factorial of number 4, it will be 4 multiplied with 3 multiplied with 2 with multiplied with 1. Okay, this is explication what about factorial. And we want to create a function that will calculate factorial. Okay, let's create a text. Cout enter the number. Okay, and line, and we can create one variable. It can be integer x, and we will simply input our variable x, and we need a text we will just write calculating factorial of, and we need variable x and some text, three dots. We suppose that it's some process. Okay, and we need to create, to calculate this, we need to create a function. Okay, it will be a function integer. We will call this function factorial, and we will have a integer a. A will be, of course, a local variable, and let's calculate. We will just type. We will need control statement first. What will be? We know what factorial is, but what will be if we enter number 0? Now what we will do? 0 multiplied with 0 multiplied with 0 multiplied with 0 with 0 with 0. It doesn't work like that. Okay, we simply, by default, we need to define that if a equals to 0, return 1. Okay, this will be a simple, because by default it will be 1, and else if it's not equal to 0, we will return a, and need to be multiplied with factorial of a minus 1. Okay. And now you are probably you are confused, but okay, what will be? Okay, we'll calculating factorial. Okay, if we enter the 0, it will be return number 1. Pretty much simple. But now, we need, if not, for example, we enter number 4. It will be 4 multiplied with factorial of 3. Okay, and but we have a function of factorial, and this function will call for herself and will start again. It's similar with a loop, and now it will be 3, and will be multiplied with 3 with factorial of 3 minus 1 will be 2. And we will get until it gets a 0. Okay, it will be 1. And okay, I think that you understand. Okay, it will work. Okay, if it is 7, we start with 7, and 7 multiplied with factorial of 6 starts again, and it will be 5, and it will be multiplied with factorial of number 4, and we will get our factorial at the end. Okay, it runs and call for herself until it comes to 0. And okay, and now let's try to implement it. Okay, calculating a factorial of variable x, and we will just call our function factorial of x, and let's write a message cout and it will be we will just type the result is and we will just call it here. We will cut and we can call it here. Okay, and we will use end line. Okay, and we will see if it will work. Okay, we will enter a variable x. Okay, and we want to calculate factorial. We write the text for that, and the result is, and we will call the function that we made, factorial of our number variable x, and let's see will it gonna work it. Let's build and run, and what we will get, we will get error because we type greater sign instead of lesser. Okay, enter the number. Let's enter number 4. Okay, calculating factorial of number 4, and the result is 24, which is good. Okay, we'll check it. Okay, 4 multiplied with 3 is 12, multiplied with 2 is 24, and multiplied with 1, okay, it still is 24. Okay, now let's run again. 5, I think that should be 120, and it is. Okay, we can calculate this until we overload integer. We can try with 3, which is pretty much simple. It will be 6 because we multiplied 3 with 2 and with 1, and the result will be 6. And let's number 10. Okay, as you can see, it is a, because these are bigger numbers, 10 multiplied with 9, multiplied with 8, multiplied with 7, And okay, but the most important thing is that this is the simplest example of the recursive function. Okay, just to explain you once. Okay, it is 5, and 5 equals 5 multiplied with factorial of number 4. Okay, 5 multiplied with factorial of 4, and okay, it will be 4, and it will be at the end, we already have 5, now we will get 4 and factorial of number 3. Okay, and we will get a number that we want. Okay, and it is the simple. We will of course use in the some of the next tutorials, we will use a recursive function for the some more complex applications, but for now it is just most important for you that you understand it. Okay, and this is the simplest example of that. Okay, I really hope that you like this video. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. You can also follow me on Twitter and Instagram. You have a link in the description, and I will see you in the next tutorial.